to you.
Hey.
What is good, Steezy Nation? Today, we're gonna do things a little bit differently. We have three dancers, Gabe Padilla, Miss Lauren Ellie, and Danielle Moulton, choreographing to a mix of a few 1990s to early 2000s hit songs. And shout out to our boy, David Lee, Steezy Studio instructional designer, for making this fire mix. Let's get it. Choreographer number one, Gabriel Padilla.
Hello friends, my name is Gabriel Padilla Jr. I've been a part of GRV, I'm a former director of Notorious, and I've had the opportunity to perform with BTS, Shinjiro Ote, and June Curry on. How long did it take me to create this? It took me about 2 to 3 days. I'm kind of a stickler for a lot of stuff. I think initially it was kind of scary hearing the mix because it felt more something to conceptualize rather than just to create. But with that idea, I kind of started to just kind of have more fun with it. So at the beginning I was like, maybe I should start on the ground. Normally if I was gonna choreograph, I would probably not do something like that.
What would be a cool way? Mike, sitting here. Goom? Scratch that one, okay. Oh, I don't even, what? I can't even do that.
To be put in front of a camera with this sort of piece, with this sort of mix, and having moments of me having to like really pop into certain things that I'm not necessarily used to, having that idea of like, okay, I can create this character and perform this, made it a little less stressful.
I'm nervous. I'm so excited. Okay. Not the floor.
Let's go, Gabe.
Not the eye contact. What?
He said, look at my fly fit.
Right. Right? Shake it.
Hey.
All you ladies pop like this. Shake your body, don't stop, don't miss. First you gotta put your neck into it. Don't stop, just do it now. Lick it.
Hey.
This is like you should my neck. All you ladies pop like this.
This is how we do.
Oh. Oh!
He said giving
isolation. Clean. Sweep the floor.
Oh! It's giving main character.
He said.
I'm okay. I can't. I feel like I have known Gabe for a while,
mm-hmm.
and this is like so out of his comfort zone. Mm-hmm. But he stepped up to it in a way that I did not expect. He used his legs really well, mm-hmm. but not just his legs, he used his levels. So you see him start on the floor, even the pump it up, he's like jumping to reach these levels. So using the area and using the space, I feel like beginner dancers can learn, like there are different levels that you can use, and he executed that very well.
I didn't expect the grooves to come out. Like I know him to be very intricate, smooth, into every single thing, really good at transitioning and travels, but to see him incorporate certain types of grooves, I'm like, he has that too, it's always good to know, like you can come back to that always. And then the performance, starting on the floor.
Ew, bye, the eye contact, he said, you gonna watch this.
Yeah.
He said, pomp it up, like.
Where y'all at, get into it, join me. He's very inclusive with his choreography, that's what I really like.
Inclusive.
Yeah, like he pulls you, he actually pulls you in.
Right, this was choreographed with the audience in mind. I cannot get over the neck part. Like, I'm gonna have to move on. For most of the people that know that song, you know that lyric is gonna come up. It was the confidence on that part, but it's also risky. And then if you do that at the club, all the ladies gonna be like, oh, my neck. So like, again.
Like you know it's coming up, but like, what are you gonna do to it?
That wordplay specifically worked really, really well because it was risky.
Hey, you know what's cooler than watching other people dance? People watching you dance. That's why we're giving away a free 1-year Steezy Studio membership every week to one lucky viewer. So make sure you tune in to our YouTube videos every single Sunday and follow the special instructions in each video for a chance to win. No more dreaming of whether or not you could kill it in a club or on stage or in a surprise dance battle. You never know when it happens, it just happens. Steezy makes it easy for you to learn dance with our custom technology, curated programs, and world-renowned instructors. All of that in the palm of your hands. For this week, you can win that 1 year membership by making sure you are subscribed to our channel, liking this video, and commenting a dance routine, move, or style that you are currently practicing and trying to improve on. Back to the video. Choreographer number two, Danielle Moulton.
Hi, my name is Danielle Moulton, and I have founded and directed two of my own teams called Vimo and LFG.
What are you interviewing for?
I don't know, I'm scared!
Be yourself.
Hi, my name is Danielle Moulton, and I have founded and directed two of my own teams called Vimo and LFG. This song is me in a minute and 10 seconds, for real. It took me 15 minutes to choreograph this piece. As soon as I heard the mix, I thought about it in my head, and then once I got into the studio, it took me 15 minutes, but this is my element.
All you ladies pop your, ooh! Ladies, pop your, like this, ooh! I can't, can I do that? All you ladies pop your, like this.
I think my favorite part was the beginning. The beginning of this song was actually the first song that Vimo used when we competed. So this was the first song that I ever choreographed to competitively. So that's why I did the Vimo thing, because that is Vimo's sign. So it was kind of a node to my own growth. I got stuck on that floor work because I had a moment where I was like, why am I doing this? I was sitting there in that little position. I was like, why? Why do you choose to do this? And I continued. So here we are now.
I'm gonna rip it. My back hurts.
I'm so excited. Little mama, there it is.
Show me how you move it.
There it is.
Put your back into it.
I can never
do your thing like it ain't nothing to it. Shake that ass, girl.
Shake that thing, bitch. Can I kinda shake that thing, bitch?
It's the look.
And I better shake that thing, yeah. Donna, donna.
All you ladies pop, pop, pop like this.
Hey.
Shake your body, don't stop, don't miss. She did that.
Big fan.
She did that. Yeah, big fan.
Overall, I mean, Danielle's presence is undeniable.
Oh my gosh. I think she was super grounded. Like, every step she took was like the biggest stomp. My favorite part is when she went a ski whoop on the floor, break her spine.
Mm-hmm.
What was yours?
For me, I was trying to pay attention to her wordplay. She had put your back, she touched her back, and then she hit it with the two. I love me a good physical, numerical.
Yes.
Here in the mix, and then seeing the kind of like dancer and performer that Danielle is, I knew she was gonna really perform. And a lot of the hard-hitting basses and the hi-hats, I knew she would tackle. But what always surprised me about Danielle is that she will capitalize on a moment and keep that moment going. For instance, like we were saying, cracking open and then going around, bringing legs up, things of that nature, so.
I feel like when I think Danielle, I think like so big, take over the whole space, like so. I feel like she actually was a lot more controlled than I expected. Like, definitely saw her intent within it. She got everything across, but super clean.
Her posture, her presence, sometimes just having that sit, and even that stare, really says a lot. It does a lot without her even really doing much of anything. And I think that's something that people may be too scared to think about because it's like, oh, I'm not doing enough.
Choreographer number three, Miss Lauren.
Hey y'all, I'm Miss Lauren, and I'm an instructor at Offstage, Snow Globe, and 88 Studios, and I've danced for some artists like Jason Derulo, CNCO, and Kenzie Ziegler. This piece took me probably a good hour. It was hard to start. Once I found my flow, it started going really well. My process, truly letting go of the idea of perfection, whatever feels good off the bat, I stick with that rather than continuously changing. When the music comes on and that's what I do, I keep it and keep moving forward. There was this one part where I felt like the musicality is crazy, so my feet had to match that. So I just went and had to keep going over and over and over again until I would get it right.
Like it ain't none to it.
had that, everything else felt like smooth sailing. Honestly, I loved my big head nods, the very intro. Gang, gang, gang. I don't know, again, with me, all about the feel good moments. So if that felt good, you can see my passion within it. Like, I love
it. Bang on that door. Little mama, sure, move it. Yep. Put your back into it. Do your thing like it ain't nothing to it. Hey. Shake that ass, girl. Shake that thing, bitch. Can I kinda shake that thing, bitch? Can I better shake that thing? Yeah. Donna, donna. All you ladies pop, pop, pop like this. Shake your body, don't stop, don't miss. Hey. First you gotta put your dick into it. Don't stop, just do it, do it, hey. Do it now. Lick it, lick it. Hey. Yeah. My back. All you ladies pop like this, like this, like this. This is how we do it. Yeah, go, pop it up.
There it is. Pop it up. Pop it up.
Just blaze. Hold up. Hey, go. Oh no. She knew. She knew. She was like, saw that?
Peace.
Yeah.
We're done.
Oh,
here.
Oh. First, roll that quick. First, you gotta put.
Oh my God. I'm not over that.
The cross legged, back facing first, the wordplay, and that jump.
And active.
Yeah. And also that energy build on that pumping up. Like, she was pumping it up.
Nah.
Is this a delay?
Sometimes we get caught up in like music, words and words, mm-hmm. messing with musicality. Mm-hmm. But then that moment of just like, just that,
yeah.
just the mm-hmm. back, mm-hmm. is what really set it for me. I was like, oh my God, you're right.
You're right.
You're right. I was like, it's just so simple. That mm-hmm. smile that she has mm-hmm. is so contagious. Mm-hmm. And like, along with the movement, like I'm definitely, like,
yeah.
she'd be like, pump it up. I'm like, okay, yeah.
Yeah, I'm pumping
yeah.
up too.
Yeah, she always looks like she's having a great time.
Piggybacking off of that, what I think that dancers can learn from Lauren is that you can have fun when you dance and you can have personality. And if you don't look like you're having fun, the audience isn't gonna have fun. So purely just looking at her face or looking at the energy she has when she turns around or when she changes style, she's able to change up her personality or even her facials with each song or section. And also knowing that she is a beginner teacher and she instills that in her students, you can see that in her movement. So hopefully people can get that from her dancing, because that is a very important part of it, in my opinion.
Word.
Get out.
Hey you, did you like this video? Heck yeah, you did. You should go ahead and physically like it, like smash that like button, maybe leave a little comment. Also, you should subscribe to Steezy. You should take some classes, they're pretty dope.
Make sure y'all subscribe, like, and comment on this video. We hope you enjoyed it, and make sure to sign up on Steezy's app to take some Steezy classes.
If you enjoyed this video, there's a lot of other videos like this on Steezy's channel, so you should go check those out. I also teach here, so you can go catch a little step with me on those online classes. Thank you.